Good morning, children. Myself G. Rajeshwari teacher from Krushi High School. I am here to teach you science subject as well as social also. So I am going to teach you science and social. So last year you have finished class 3. Now you have entered into class 4. So you may be already watching the Max class as well as Telugu class. So now you have to watch the science class. It is little different from your classrooms. What all you'll do in the classroom will not be there in the online class. Just you have to listen the classes and you have to follow the instructions. What teacher is saying? Is she asking to write? Is she asking to read? Is she asking to draw? So whatever instructions teachers are giving, that you have to follow. It's very simple. And try to listen the classes carefully. Now we'll enter into the chapter number 1. So today's date, class 4, subject science, lesson number 1, plant life. What is your lesson number 1? Plant life. So when I'm explaining the lesson, you please take the textbook and listen the class. Just you have to listen the class when I am explaining the lesson. Once and twice I am telling you this thing. So plants make their own food. This is the unit plant life. In this we are going to learn plants make their own food. What is food? Are you eating the food? Yes, it may be a fruit or vegetable or rice, anything that fills your stomach when you are hungry is food. So how do plants make their own food? How do plants make their food? So when you feel hungry, what do you do? Meeku aakalu esinappudu meeru em chestaru? You'll go to the mama. You'll ask your mother, I'm feeling hungry, I want to eat something. It may be a snack, it may be a fruit, it may be a vegetable, or it may be a rice. Otherwise you'll go to the kitchen and you'll find the utensils. You'll search what is there to eat. Is there any chocolate? Is there any biscuit? Will you find like this? Will you search? Yes, many of you search in the kitchen for these things, and when you feel hungry you'll eat it. So how does a plant eat? Can plant go to the kitchen? Can it will go outside? Or it will ask you? No, it will not ask you and it will not go out in search for the food. So how it is able to prepare the food? Let us see. So before that, do you know how do you get your food? How do you get an apple? From a tree. So how do you get rice? From paddy plants. And how is the food prepared? Don't know. Your mother will prepare the food in the kitchen. Yes, if you want Maggie, what will your mother do? She'll go to the kitchen and she'll prepare the Maggie. Is it right? Yes. So this all process is called as cooking. If your mother gives you Maggie, if your mother gives you biryani or anything, whatever you ask. If you ask biryani, your mother will give you biryani. Yes. So when the process of making biryani or Maggie or a sweet or a rice or vegetable, this is all are called as cooking. What is this said to be? Cooking. So how is that you are getting food? By cooking. In the same way, plants are making the food. So what is this process called? Photosynthesis. Plants prepare their own food by the process called photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. What is the meaning of photo here? Light. Photo means light. Synthesis means putting together. Putting together. So, the way we prepare the food is called as cooking, and the way the plants prepare the food is called as photosynthesis. That is the difference. So, here, what is the photosynthesis? Photo means light. Synthesis means putting together. Let us now learn how photosynthesis takes place in a plant. To understand the process of photosynthesis, let us think of it as a recipe. So, what is the recipe of a Maggie? First, mama will boil the Maggie in the water. Then later on, she'll add the masala. This is the recipe of Maggie. In the same way, you think of the photosynthesis like a recipe. Before your mother starts cooking, what does she do? She keep all the ingredients ready. So, when she is going to prepare anything, Maggie or something, what she'll do? She'll take the all ingredients together. Maggie packet, masala packet, or the utensils, or the oil, onions, carrots, anything. All she'll take together and she'll start preparing the recipe. In the same way, when plant is under the photosynthesis process, it will also take all the ingredients. Now, what are the ingredients for the photosynthesis? Let us see the ingredients. Water, minerals, carbon dioxide, sunlight. So, to prepare the food, plants need water, minerals, carbon dioxide and sunlight. So, will the plant move from one place to another place to take the water, to take the minerals, to take the sunlight? No. It will stay in the same place and it will absorb all these and it will start preparing the food. So, first a plant needs water to make food and it also needs some minerals. Where are the minerals present? Where will the plant go to take the minerals? It will find the minerals in the water. Minerals are present in the water as well as in the soil. So, how the roots absorb the water with the minerals from the soil? Here the roots. These are the roots of the plant. What does these roots do? They will take the, suppose these are the minerals. What are these? Minerals, but you cannot see with your eyes. Okay, so these minerals are absorbed by the roots from the soil. Here we are having the soil. What is there under the ground? Soil. So the roots, what they'll do, they will take the minerals from the soil with the help of the water. We'll pour the water, right? We'll pour the water to the tree. So what happens? The water from the stem, this is the stem. So from the stem, the water will go to the roots and the roots will absorb the minerals from the soil with the help of this water. In this way, the plants take minerals and water. And the water will pour here. We'll pour the water here. So, the water from the roots, it will go through the stem. We are pouring water here. So, the roots will absorb the water and it will absorb the minerals and it will send through the stem. Here, from here, the water and the minerals, the roots are sending the water and the minerals through the stem. This is the stem. From the stem to the leaves. From the stem to the leaves. From here again the water is distributed to the leaves. Carbon dioxide is another important ingredient needed for photosynthesis. And what is the next ingredient? Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide. several times I am repeating it so that you can pronounce it. Some children may not pronounce it properly, so don't spell it wrong. Listen carefully. Water, minerals, carbon dioxide. You have to split it and read. If you are unable to read it, you have to split it. You have to divide it. Like C-A-R, car. B-O-N, born. D-I, die. O-X-I-D-E, oxide. So you have to divide it and you have to learn to spell it. Carbon dioxide. Do you know where plants get it from? Where do the plants get carbon dioxide? You have already learned that there are tiny openings called stomata underside the leaves. These stomata taking carbon dioxide from the air. So, this is a leaf. In the leaf, we cannot see with our eyes. You can see through a microscope some small tiny holes. What is there? Small tiny holes. So some small tiny holes are there in the leaf. What does it will do? It will take the carbon dioxide that is present in the air. Here, air is there. So what is there in the air? Carbon dioxide as well as oxygen. So we will take the oxygen and we will give out the carbon dioxide. So the carbon dioxide that is present in the air, these stomata will take the carbon dioxide. Do you have nose? So what does the nose do? It will take the oxygen that is present in the air. So here the stomata is taking the carbon dioxide. This stomata is called as the nose for the plant. Stomata acts like a nose for the plant. So in this way they are taking water, minerals, carbon dioxide. And a plant needs sunlight also to prepare the food. The leaves contain a substance called chlorophyll. So, here the leaf also contains the chlorophyll substance. What does it contain? Chlorophyll. So, what does this chlorophyll do? It will absorb the sunlight. It will absorb the sunlight. The chlorophyll that is present in the leaf will absorb the sunlight. So now the plant has taken all the ingredients to prepare the food. Today we have finished one page of this lesson. And today's homework. Write heading, lesson number 1, plant life and plants make their food. On the first line, in your first line you have to write, plants make their food. Plants make their own food. It is here. Plants make their own food. And leave one line. You have to leave one line. In next line you write keywords. Write keywords. I am going to give you 5 keywords today. And you have to write it 3 times. First one, hungry, H-U-N-G-R-Y, hungry. What is this? H-U-N-G-R-Y, hungry. Next, factories, F-A-C-T-O-R-I-E-S, factories. Third one, photosynthesis, P-H-O-T-O-S-Y-N-T-H-E-S-I-S, photosynthesis. And fourth one, ingredients, I-N-G-R-E-D-I-E-N-T-S, ingredients. Once again I am repeating, H-U-N-G-R-Y, hungry. Second one, factories, factories. Third one, photosynthesis, photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Fourth one, ingredients, ingredients. Ingredients. And fifth one, minerals, minerals. Minerals. So these five hard words you have to write it three times. This is your homework. Learn and write given hard words, given keywords three times. Okay, this is your homework. And what is the classwork today? We have listened the lesson. That is your classwork. And this is your homework. Thank you, children.